the early years. In a career encompassing over 100 movies, Jackie Chan has risen from his humble beginnings as a stunt player and extra at the famous Shaw Brothers Studios to almost legendary status as the world's number one action star. Jackie's breathtaking career, both as actor and director, has produced some of the most original, daring, and exciting action adventures ever made. The selfless performance of the death-defying stunts, which have almost cost him his life on several occasions, has created a fan base for his work, which is the envy of every other major star in the business. Born in Hong Kong on April 7, 1954, under the birth name of Chan Kong Sang, few people would have predicted the success that lay ahead for Jackie Chan. It is already an integral part of Hong Kong filmmaking legend that Jackie's family was so poor that they offered to sell him to the British doctor who delivered him, as they could not afford to pay the medical bills or even feed him. Eventually reconsidering their offer, Chan's father and mother found work at the French consulate in Hong Kong before moving to Australia to work at the U.S. Embassy when Jackie was just a child. Returning back to Hong Kong at the age of six, Jackie was enrolled by his father for a period of 10 years at the Chinese Opera Academy. From 5 in the morning to midnight, the young Chan was subjected to an arduous training program covering all the techniques of Peking Opera. Under the constant threat of severe corporal punishment, the students were taught acrobatics, a variety of martial arts, singing, dancing, mime, and acting. Yu Chai-yuan, the draconian disciplinarian in charge of the school, soon recognized young Chan's talent and integrated the youngster into his elite student performance group called the Seven Little Fortunes. It was while performing for the troupe that Jackie began his lifelong association with fellow martial arts luminaries Sammo Hung and Yun Biu. The three brothers have each contributed to some of the most thrilling, innovative, and technically difficult martial arts sequences ever recorded on film. The best of their projects together are Project A, Wheels on Meals, and Dragons Forever. Jackie began his film career at age 8 in Big and Little Wong Tin Bar in 1962 and is said to have made more than 25 films by age 10. By 17, with years of strict operatic training behind him, Jackie began his love affair with performing martial arts and stunt sequences for the camera. While performing stunts for Shaw Brothers and Golden Harvest, Jackie showed a level of courage, determination, and technical ability which put him well ahead of the majority of his peers. Most notably during this period, Jackie appeared in two movies with Bruce Lee, Fist of Fury and Enter the Dragon. In Fist, while serving as a stunt double for the ominous Mr. Suzuki, Chan executed what was reportedly the highest unprotected fall ever attempted in a Hong Kong movie, and duly earned enthusiastic praise from Mr. Lee as a result of his efforts. Jackie's first leading role came in the 1971 vehicle Little Tiger from Guangdong. A number of supporting roles then followed, including most notably his scene-stealing performance in the 1976 John Woo feature Hand of Death, alongside Kung Fu brothers Sammo Hung and Yun Biu, with Chan also acting as fight choreographer. After signing a restrictive contract with former Bruce Lee director Lo Wei, Jackie gained top billing in New Fist of Fury in 1976, but failed to make any significant impact at the box office. Although Jackie went on to make 9 movies for Lo Wei, they all failed to establish him as a star in Hong Kong, where audiences were still inconsolable over the loss of Bruce Lee and would not accept anyone who set themselves up as a direct replacement. Ironically, as time passed and audiences both foreign and domestic became less subjective, the appreciation for these early films grew steadily amongst fans of the genre. There is no doubt that the technical delivery of the martial arts in titles such as Snake and Crane Arts of Shaolin, Dragon Fist, and Spiritual Kung Fu is nothing short of superb, and fight scenes are sufficiently plentiful to satisfy even the most ardent fight junkie. Jackie openly admits that he put his heart and soul into the fight choreography for Snake and Crane Arts of Shaolin, and still regards the movie's 15 detailed sequences as some of his best work. A Star is Born. In 1978, reportedly against the advice of most of the distributors in Asia, visionary producer Ung Si-yuan, believing Jackie required a change in image, cast him in his forthcoming action comedy Snake in the Eagle's Shadow. Working closely with NG and director Yuen Wu-ping, Jackie developed a timeless mix of kung fu and comedy, which has become his trademark ever since. When the movie turned into a runaway hit in Hong Kong, taking just under 3 million Hong Kong dollars at the box office, Jackie was transformed into a star almost overnight. The detailed dynamic fight choreography and jaw-dropping training sequences first seen in Snake in the Eagle's Shadow were again used to amazing effect in Jackie's second project for seasonal films, Drunken Master, released in 1979. This movie, which takes a delightful sideways look at legendary fighter Wong Fei-hung, was an even bigger hit than Snake. When it took 8 million Hong Kong dollars at the Hong Kong box office, Jackie's star rose confidently into the stratosphere. For fight fans, there is much to enjoy. In particular, the end fight sequence where Jackie uses the style of the Eight Drunken Gods to defeat kicking genius Wong Jong-li is a seminal classic of martial arts action cinema that has defined Chan's image for a generation of adoring fans all over the world. After Drunken Master, Jackie returned to Lo Wei to complete his contractual obligation with one last film. Now, with the power of two hit movies behind him, Jackie was finally given creative control for Fearless Hyena. This movie has the enduring honor of achieving the second highest box office gross in Hong Kong movie history, and also marks Chan's debut as both director and screenwriter. Once again, the fight scenes are powerful and full of emotion, and the audience is treated to feats of incredible physical prowess, such as Jackie's flawless performance of 14 consecutive upside-down sit-ups while suspended from a tree. Trial and Error. After Fearless Hyena, Jackie set up his own production company, Golden Way, with manager Willie Chan, and worked out a distribution deal with studio boss Raymond Chow at Golden Harvest. In 1980, he became Hong Kong's first bona fide movie star, walking off with a cool $1 million paycheck for his part in The Young Master. Filled with intricate, masterfully choreographed action sequences, clever sight gags, and fluid camera work, Jackie excels in his role as both director and principal lead. The inventive kinetic complexity of the fan fight and the raw savagery of the relentless 20-minute bone-crunching finale with Korean super kicker Wong Yu-sik are both timeless. When enthusiastic Hong Kong cinema audiences helped the movie break box office records, producer Raymond Chow decided it was time for Jackie to appear in his first American-produced feature. Appearing in both Battle Creek Brawl and The Cannonball Run in 1980, Jackie soon realized that the Western market was going to be a tough nut to crack. Sadly, the first film failed to fulfill its potential due to a flawed marketing campaign. The second, although very successful, failed to bring Jackie any significant personal recognition, as he was completely overshadowed by a myriad of established stars, including Dean Martin, Farrah Fawcett, Sammy Davis Jr., and leading man Burt Reynolds at the height of his popularity. It was not until the mid to late 80s, when Jackie had established himself as a genius in the action genre, that respect grew steadily for his work in Battle Creek Brawl. Indeed, there is a lot to appreciate. The displays of lightning-fast combination handwork on show during the theater fight sequence are undeniably impressive. Similarly, Jackie's freeform four-point bicycle kick, performed effortlessly without a wire, is a moment of physical genius which very few other performers can match. It is a shame that Western audiences did not fully appreciate the full extent of Jackie's talent at this time, as he could have been an international star at a much earlier point in his prolific career. Returning to Hong Kong, Jackie took another gamble with Dragon Lord in 1982. Originally titled Young Master in Love, as a homage to his earlier film, Dragon Lord marked the creation of a new form of action comedy. Replacing the flashy, intricate fight scenes made famous in previous movies came bone-crunching stunts and quickly edited contemporary punching and kicking. Interestingly, this movie still holds the Guinness World Record for the highest number of takes required for one scene in a motion picture, courtesy of the shuttlecock kicking sequence. After finishing Fantasy Mission Force for One-Armed Swordsman star Jimmy Wang Yu in the second half of 1982, Jackie spent almost all of 1983 filming Project A, which he also wrote and directed. Conscious of the need to keep his face in the public eye, Jackie also appeared during 83 in Cannonball Run 2 for director Hal Needham, and in Winners and Sinners for old pal Sammo Hung. Winners and Sinners was the first project in director Hung's incredibly successful Lucky Stars action comedy series, which would eventually run for 5 films. A hair-raising roller skating sequence where Jackie weaves in and out of rush hour traffic and skates below the undercarriage of a moving container lorry takes the honors for best action sequence. A close second is the high-impact restaurant fight, which culminates in Chan's magnificent execution of a slow-motion spinning back kick, sending his opponent tumbling corkscrew fashion through a plate glass window. Building a legacy. Feeling the need to answer the skeptics who felt that his career was going down the pan during the early 80s, Jackie bounced back with considerable style. Project A, when finally released in 84, was a genre masterpiece and quite deservedly took over 14 million Hong Kong dollars in its first week at the Hong Kong box office. Jackie was back with a vengeance. The show-stopping Clock Tower Fall, inspired by Harold Lloyd's Safety Last, had audiences clapping and cheering and gasping in sheer disbelief at the outrageous courage required to pull off this incredible stunt. Without doubt, the inventiveness and outstanding physical ability profiled in the fight sequences is a tribute to the skill and knowledge of the triumvirate of main players. Jackie, Sammo Hung, and Yuen Biu prove themselves again to be true masters of their art as they kick, punch, and flip their way through the amazing cavern fight sequence which rounds up the movie. The final three-on-one fight against evil pirate king San Pao, played with gusto by veteran Dick Way, is a masterpiece of rhythm and timing, with each of our heroes taking turns to unleash varied attacks to wear down a seemingly unbeatable opponent, vintage Chan. Jackie's next two films with Kung Fu brothers Sammo and Biu are generally regarded as two of the best by fight fans on both sides of the Atlantic. In the first, Wheels on Meals, released in 1984, principal photography took place in Barcelona, Spain. To give the project a truly international feel, Jackie and Sammo contracted the services of formidable full-contact champ Benny the Jet Urquidez and form specialist Keith Vitale to play the roles of principal villains. From the amazing stunt-packed car sequence to the breathtaking plaza fight where Jackie dislodges an attacker from his motorcycle with a perfectly executed flying kick, right through to the awesome three-way end fight scene, Wheels on Meals is a winner from start to finish. Jackie's incredible battle with Benny the Jet is often cited as one of the best fights ever recorded on film, and quite deservedly so. Both performers are a joy to watch as they kick and punch through one of the most realistic encounters ever filmed. In the interests of authenticity, Benny and Jackie were actually hitting each other for real on many occasions. And for many fans, Jackie's gymnastic kicking performance has seldom been bettered. The second outing, My Lucky Stars, was shot in Japan in 1985 due to Jackie's amazing popularity there. Following the opening car chase through Tokyo, Jackie and Biu battle ninja warriors in a theme park in the shadow of Mount Fuji. When Bew is kidnapped at the end of the encounter, the chase is on. Let down at the last minute by one of the project's principal contributors, Sammo enlisted the help of Jackie and Eric Tsang to lend a hand with the directing duties. To make the all-important Chinese New Year release date, Jackie, Sammo, and Eric filmed different sections of the movie around the clock. Not only did they make a seemingly impossible deadline, but they also broke another record when My Lucky Stars took 10 million Hong Kong dollars in its first week of release, before going on to attain 30 million Hong Kong dollars by the end of its run. Golden Harvest boss Raymond Chow was so overwhelmed by the movie's success that he hosted a gala dinner for cast and crew, including a symbolic smashing of a $30 million ice carving by all the stars. The finished project boasts many amazing set pieces. The frenetic, action-packed finale, which features Jackie, Sammo, and Bew taking on Japanese gangsters in an amusement park, is a real showstopper. It's also memorable for the revealing debut performance of Japanese bodybuilding babe Michiko Nishiwaki. Her hilarious one-punch knockout at the hands of the great Sammo Hung is worth the price of admission alone. The Gambler Returns. In the latter half of 1985, Jackie tried once again to break the American market with action thriller The Protector, written and directed by James Glickenhaus. Unfortunately, the project was doomed from the start, as it was derivative and badly written. And Glickenhaus refused to let Jackie create any of the fight scenes, despite his considerable expertise. Naturally, it flopped. And Jackie, saddened, went back to Hong Kong and reshot the action for the movie's release in his home territory, improving it greatly. With the Protector experience still fresh in his mind, Jackie felt he had a point to make and began work on his own cop thriller, Police Story, during 1985. In the same year, he also found time to make Heart of the Dragon and Twinkle Twinkle Lucky Stars for Big Brother Sammo. Heart of the Dragon, a.k.a. The First Mission, was Jackie's first truly dramatic role. Once again, he plays a police officer caught in a conflict between enjoying life on the open sea as a merchant seaman and staying at home to look after his mentally retarded older brother, played with sensitivity by Sammo. In comparison to some of Jackie's other movies, Heart was a failure at the Hong Kong box office, taking just over 1 million Hong Kong dollars, as fans seemed to be disappointed by the serious content of the project. Regardless of its box office credentials, this movie showcases some of the best fight scenes of Jackie's career. Choreographer Yuen Biu went for a very fast, direct, and more street-realistic style, and Jackie excels with his execution of technique in each of the three principal fights. Of particular note is the finale showcase, which unfolds in a multi-story construction site. Here, Jackie takes on gun-toting gangsters, axe-wielding construction workers, and a formidable supervillain, played again with relish by the ubiquitous Dick Way. This scene is a genuine masterclass in editing, action photography, and fight choreography, and is a testament to a director, choreographer, and lead actor on top form. Fight fans should note that it is best to search out the Chinese version, as the international print is devoid of two excellent fight scenes, one in a drug rehabilitation center and the other in a car park. Raising the Bar. Upon its release, Police Story was greeted with great acclaim and is actually thought by many to be the first great modern-day martial arts action adventure. It certainly ranks as one of the principal highlights in Jackie's career. The fight choreography is full-blooded and electrified with emotional underscoring. The stunt sequences, which led to many of Jackie's stunt team being carried off to hospital, were truly groundbreaking. If the best form of flattery is imitation, then Jackie should be truly flattered, as Andrei Konchalovsky directly lifted several scenes for Tango and Cash. Director Dwight H. Little also used the shopping mall motorcycle sequence frame by frame for the opening scenes of Rapid Fire, starring the late Brandon Lee. Not surprisingly, Police Story was a blazing success, and Jackie went into 1986 on a high. Armor of God, an Indiana Jones-style action-adventure produced in the same year, again scored big on the adrenalinometer and features an impressive array of precision driving stunts. The banquet hall fight sequence plays like a masterclass seminar for choreographers and action directors and counts among some of Chan's best work. On the downside, the movie very nearly cost Jackie his life when he mistimed a leap from a castle wall into a tree. Plummeting headfirst to the ground, he cracked his skull on a rock, receiving a potentially fatal injury. Only the skill of the surgeon saved his life, and today Jackie suffers from partial deafness in one ear and a penny-sized hole on the right side of his head as a direct result of the fall. In 1987, Jackie made the long-awaited sequel to one of his best-loved movies, Project A. In a worthy tribute, the sequel features detailed period sets, elaborate handmade costumes, balletic fights, and some of Jackie's best stunt work, and is a definite winner. The elaborate high fall through a bamboo lattice, although brilliantly executed, certainly counts as one of Chan's most reckless moments, and he was extremely lucky not to sustain another serious injury. Dragons Forever, also released in 87, is the last movie to date in which Jackie appears with Kung Fu brothers Sammo Hung and Yuen Biu. Although the film performed badly in Japan, the action scenes are top drawer. Yuen Biu gives an acrobatic show-stopping performance, and Jackie squares off against kickboxing sensation Benny the Jet Urquidez, his nemesis from Wheels on Meals, for one of the best one-on-one battles ever filmed. 1988's Police Story 2 quite rightly won the award for Best Choreography at the Hong Kong Film Awards. The movie is littered with amazing fights and stunt sequences, and Jackie's tour de force battle with triad mobsters in a deserted playground is one of his best ever. Beginning with some brilliantly executed evasive maneuvers and combination punching, the sequence then moves into double stick combat and culminates in Jackie being chased down an alleyway by two gangsters in a 4x4 cruiser. The escape is classic Chan, with Jackie running up the wall, spinning around in the air, and then using his forward momentum to kick through the windscreen. Jackie's next project, Miracles, released in 1987, is a martial arts comic melodrama set in the 1930s, which took 9 months to shoot and cost 64 million Hong Kong dollars to make. The subtle Scorsese-inspired tracking shots, elegant montages, and innovative action sequences indicate the level of care and attention that Jackie put into this labor of love, inspired by Pocketful of Miracles. Even today, the movie rates as one of the most technically proficient projects ever produced by a Hong Kong studio. As well as its technical accolades, this movie is also a must for action fans. All four fights are very well conceived. The end finale is particularly satisfying, with Jackie again demonstrating his evasive fighting style by dodging bodies, barrels, and hemp rollers before going toe-to-toe with Thai boxing sensation Billy Chow. It is in this end sequence that Jackie demonstrates some of the best combination kicking of his career, using spinning back and crescent kicks to destabilize his powerful opponent. The director takes a rest. During filming of Armor of God 2 Operation Condor in 1990, Jackie found time to star in Island of Fire as another favor to Jimmy Wang Yu. Best described as a tribute to both Cool Hand Luke and the Wild Geese, the cast and crew braved massive interruptions caused by the Gulf War to turn out a dark and exhilarating action drama featuring Jackie's most intense fight scene since Heart of the Dragon. Sammo Hung, Andy Lau, and Tony Leung give excellent support as usual, and the haunting score adds immeasurably to the overall effect. For collectors, the impossibly rare Taiwanese cut of the movie features over 30 minutes of additional footage. Directed by veteran Choi Hark as a cash-raising vehicle for the Hong Kong Directors Guild, Jackie's 1991 vehicle Twin Dragons is the story of two identical twin brothers separated at birth, who are then drawn together by fate to take on heavy-hitting triad mobsters. The movie's highlights are Jackie's tour de force fight scenes in a Mitsubishi car testing facility during the final reels, when he displays some amazingly dangerous stunts and innovative fighting techniques. Next up was the action-packed Police Story 3 Super Cop, directed by ex-stunt god Stanley Tong and co-starring action babe par excellence Michelle Yeoh. Distinguished as the film that brought Jackie the Best Actor Award at the Golden Horse Awards in Taiwan, it also represents the first time Jackie used his real voice for sync sound recording in a Cantonese film. For many fans, Michelle Yeoh stole the show with her high-kicking fight sequences and daring motorcycle stunts during the final reels. But Jackie definitely contributes to the madness by hanging underneath a helicopter which is traveling at full speed hundreds of feet off the ground. 1993's City Hunter, an action comedy based on the popular manga and anime character Ryu Seiba, is a colorful, high-spirited romp with comic tributes to Bruce Lee's Game of Death and arcade hit Street Fighter II. Populist director Wong Jing keeps things moving at a lightning pace from beginning to end. Most notably, the movie features an amazing skateboarding sequence, two great fight scenes with British kickboxing hero Gary Daniels, and a wonderful high-impact encounter with veteran Australian performer and all-round nice guy Richard Norton. In stark contrast, Kirk Wong's Crime Story, released in the same year, is an edgy, hard-hitting crime thriller based on the true story about a businessman who was kidnapped twice and held for a ransom of $6 million. Originally planned for Jet Li, Jackie picked up the lead role as a favor to director Wong when Jet returned to China in the aftermath of the murder of his manager at the hands of the Triads. The movie features the actual destruction of the infamous Walled City, a long-time criminal safe haven in the heart of Hong Kong, and the footage with Jackie running through the streets as buildings explode around him in full pyrotechnic splendor is undoubtedly the movie's best sequence. Dreams Fulfilled. By all accounts, 1994 was a major milestone in the remarkable career of Jackie Chan. Not only did he make what many fans feel is his best film of the 90s, The Matchless Drunken Master 2, but he also completed Rumble in the Bronx. This movie would finally make Jackie a star in the United States when it was re-edited and redubbed by New Line Cinema for cinematic release there in 1996. Determined to come up with a sequel that would be a worthy follow-up to the original classic, which had made him a star back in 79, Jackie worked tirelessly on Drunken Master 2 to create some of the most memorable, intricate, and electrifying fight action ever recorded on film. Each of the movie's fights is incredible, but the end sequence featuring Jackie's super-kicking real-life bodyguard Ken Lo is absolutely priceless. Filmed in Vancouver, as indicated by the snow-covered mountains standing in for downtown New York, Rumble in the Bronx opens with an amazing Wing Chun training routine and features an incredible aerial jump from a roof onto a balcony, all captured in a glorious slow-motion, multi-angled montage. Full marks to the New Line marketing team, who did an incredible job taking the film to the number one spot on the U.S. theatrical charts during its opening week, raking in an impressive $10 million in the process. Next up was the release of racing car drama Thunderbolt in 1995. As Jackie was still suffering from the effects of breaking his ankle on the set of Rumble, the fight scenes are obtusely filmed by director Sammo Hung to hide Jackie's injury. Thanks to the numerous high-impact auto racing scenes, Thunderbolt cost a record 2 billion Hong Kong dollars, 25 million U.S. dollars, another landmark in Jackie's remarkable career. As an affectionate tribute to the James Bond movies, Jackie released Police Story 4 First Strike in 1996. The latter fight won Jackie an MTV award, but the end fight with a rubber shark is unfortunately pretty much the last thing you see. Mr. Nice Guy, Jackie's 1997 collaboration with director Sammo Hung, features Jackie as a kung fu chef and is notable for the new vari-speed camera techniques employed during the action sequences. In an impressive battle on a building site where Jackie takes on gangsters led by veteran Richard Norton, he flips and counterpunches and uses his environment in a variety of creative ways to avoid capture. Fulfilling his commitment to Asian audiences while waiting for a suitable project to follow up his success with Rumble in the States, Jackie completes work on Who Am I in 1998. Shot mostly in South Africa and Rotterdam, the action is a high-tech blend of martial arts, gunplay, and precision driving, and features a standout rooftop battle with Dutch kickboxing champion Ron Smurenberg, which shows Jackie back in good form. Jackie Chan 2001 and Beyond. Currently gaining the respect of fans worldwide is Jackie's new action thriller, The Accidental Spy, directed by award-winning helmer Teddy Chan, the man behind Downtown Torpedoes and Purple Storm. Making full use of a number of exotic locations, including Korea and Turkey, this production is one of the biggest in Hong Kong cinema history, and the cinematography and art design are taken to a new level. This time around, Jackie plays the lead role of Buck, a salesman at a sports equipment store, who is plunged into a life of action and adventure after accidentally foiling a robbery at a jewelry store. Co-starring Taiwanese singer-actor Vivian Hsu and former TV reporter Babe Kim Hin, the movie features a number of blistering action sequences as Jackie tracks down a mysterious and lethal virus while relentlessly pursued by competing parties. Scenes containing the high-impact martial artistry for which Jackie is famous are not as prominent as one would expect, but there are plenty of Western-style action sequences by way of compensation, and fans of the original Speed movie will instantly recognize the high-energy homage in the final reels. Jackie's next cinematic project will be the eagerly awaited sequel to his $240 million U.S. dollar worldwide box office hit Rush Hour. Written by Speed 2 architect Jeff Nathanson, the story will kick off exactly where the first one left off, with Chan and Tucker traveling to Hong Kong, although portions of the movie are also being shot in New York and Las Vegas, to provide a truly international flavor to the production. Producer Arthur Sarkisian has reunited both Jackie and Chris Tucker in their original roles, and Brett Ratner has also returned as director. The movie is currently in post-production and is scheduled for release on the U.S. theatrical circuit on August 3, 2001. Next on Jackie's busy agenda is the supernatural action fantasy Highbinders, to be shot on location in Ireland. Produced by Emperor Group's Alfred Chung, the movie will be directed by famed Fist of Legend helmer Gordon Chan, with action choreography by celebrated action maestro Sammo Hung. Jackie will, of course, play the lead role as a tough, no-nonsense cop killed in the line of duty, who returns from the grave as a Highbinder, an individual with supernatural powers who is bound to a higher purpose. The project, which will also star fast-talking British comedy talent Lee Evans and promises a number of high-impact fight sequences, will combine wire-assisted combat with Jackie's traditional knockout fighting techniques and stunt sequences. With a budget of $35 million U.S. dollars, the movie will be the biggest project ever financed by a Hong Kong studio, overtaking the previous record set by Jackie's Golden Harvest blockbuster, The Accidental Spy. Regular Hong Kong Legends fans will also be interested to know that audio commentary maestro Bai Logan will be heavily involved in the development of the script. Other potential projects in development are The Giant, to be directed by longtime Chan collaborator Frankie Chan. If made, the project will be a big-budget action drama to be filmed in Shanghai and Japan, and Jackie will play an ex-member of the Chinese national gymnastic team, forced into retirement through injury, who enters a triathlon-style iron contest to win money for a friend in need. The second project under development is the high-tech action thriller Nosebleed. Derived from a concept by Stu Zickerman and Raven Metzner, Jackie will play a window cleaner at the World Trade Center, who falls in love with a waitress working in the windows of the World restaurant, and then becomes embroiled in a plot to bomb the Twin Towers. As events in Jackie's prolific and fast-moving career change so quickly, please visit his official website at www.jackie-chan.com for regular updates and developments as they occur.